In the currency quadrant today, let's look at the yen, which had a pretty massive reversal. We'll call it a safety reversal, or a reversal of the flight to safety trade, which extended to new highs and then reversed again. The entire two-day move that happened after the killing of General Soleimani took the yen futures all the way up to 93.15. Well, today, overnight, with the Iranian retaliation, we got up to 93.24. Again, all a flight to safety move, getting out of currencies that could be in danger geopolitically and getting into something like the yen, which is fairly safe given the amount of the Japanese population that owns their own bonds. That's the theory behind it. So getting all the way up to 93.24 and then collapsing below the lows of December 31st, all the way down to 91.87, again, futures contract on this, that's 175% extension reversal past that two-day flight to safety trade. So clearly, we took the flight to safety trade off and then some. Then we had some Japanese data that also kind of pushed the Japanese yen lower. Real earnings in Japan came in weaker than expected. They're expected to come out at down 0.7. They came out at down 0.9. Then we also had Japanese consumer confidence, another little data point that came out better than the last reading of 38 and change. Came out at about 39.1. was expected to come out at about 39.5. So both of those weaker than expected. Also a little bit of a driver in the yen going to the downside. And then of course, the dollar index had its largest up move in 2 months, getting all the way back up above 97 again after an early dip, reversed in the same way that the yen did. So being one of the major pairs involved against the dollar with the dollar index, obviously if the dollar is stronger, it's going to give a little bit of a headwind to the yen specifically.